Did you know that you can make money when the markets go down? Yes, it's true. And one way that you can do this is by shorting the stock. Shorting a stock means that you want the stock to go down, so you are considered a bear. You short a stock by borrowing shares from your broker, and then you sell them to someone else in hopes that the stock will go down in value. Then you buy the stock back once it's gone down to be a cheaper price, and then you give those shares back to your broker. For example, sometimes when a new hot toy comes out and it goes out of stock, you find it very expensive on sites like eBay. This is because so many people want this product, but yet all the stores don't have it, so there's no supply but tons of demand. Say that your friend got that hot new toy for $100. And he let you borrow it. And you saw that on eBay, it was going for $400. So you decide to sell your friend's toy on eBay for $400. Remember, this isn't your toy. You never paid a dime for it. It's your friend's toy, and he let you borrow it. He paid for it. At this point, you have $400, and your friend is out his toy. A few days later, the store gets that toy back in stock for $100. So you go and buy it from the store for $100. Now you give your friend that new toy that you just got. Now you get to pocket the difference, being $300. So in stock terms, the toy was a share of the stock. You borrow the toy or a share from your friend, who would be the broker. Then you sell the borrowed toy or share to someone else who wants it. In the example, you sold the toy on eBay for top dollar. And that's exactly what you would want to do with the stock market. You'd want to sell those borrowed shares as high as possible. Then when the price goes down, you buy it back cheaper than what you sold it for. Then you get to keep the difference. Essentially, it's the exact opposite of going long a stock. Instead of buying, then selling, you are selling, then buying. In your account, when you buy a stock, it will say you own shares. When you short a stock, it will say you have negative shares. In order for you to get out of the position, you'll have to cover your position. Or in other words, you have to buy back the stock by putting in a bid to buy it from someone else. You need to cover your position because your broker will want their shares that they lent you back. Like in the example, you had to buy another toy to give back to your friend. In this video, we're going to discuss the biggest risks with shorting stocks. So first off, one of the biggest problems with shorting stocks is you have unlimited risk. The stock can go however high it wants, so you can potentially have more significant losses, even over 100%. Whereas when you buy a stock, the stock can only go to zero, so you can only lose 100% of what you put in. Let's go back to the toy example. Say that the toy never came back in stock, and maybe became discontinued, causing the item to be a collectible. And now it's gone up in value like crazy. There is no limit to what it could be worth. In a few years, it could be going for $5,000 on eBay, and you sold it for $400. Now you'd be out the difference of the $400 to the $5,000. Something else to think about with shorting stocks is it can move against you very quickly on what is called a short squeeze. This is when the short trader's trade is going against them. So they are short, but the stock is still going up in value. Now, shorts know that they have unlimited risk potential. They will typically have a price point where they want to stop out or be done with the trade and take the loss. Now, imagine that the stock hits that price point and there are a ton of traders that are short the position, now having to cover or buy back their shares. So now you have the traders that think the stock is going up buying the stock, and you have the traders that think the stock is going down buying the stock. because it is going up too fast for them, they can't hold on to their position. This squeezes them out of their position and causes a huge move to the upside. Some traders focus heavily on finding stocks that are having a short squeeze move. This will typically happen with the smaller cap stocks that have a lower float. But of course, it can happen with the mid and the large caps as well. We'll dive deeper into this short squeeze topic, but for now, that is it, and I will see you in the next video.